everybody. This is Dr. Ryan Barron with High Point Spine and Joint Center. I'm a board certified chiropractic physician. If you've been into our office or anything, into our clinic, you know that I go in between Kimball and Sydney. And so while I'm on the road, I wanted to make a few videos just answering some of the very common questions that we get asked every day. And a lot of these are questions that patients call in with, wondering if we can help them even before they ever come into the office. But the biggest question that I wanted to start with today was, can you adjust me, or can I see a chiropractor after I've had spinal surgery? And the short answer to that question is yes, you can be seen. Now, it's more complex than that, just because there's multiple different types of surgeries. But I kind of lump them into two different classes. You have surgeries that are involved by a neurosurgeon, but they don't leave a lot of hardware in after the surgery. For example, laminectomies, discectomies. Cut off just a small chunk of the vertebra. They go through there and they trim out a disc. That's called a laminectomy, or even a discectomy if they go clear to the disc. It provides more room within the spinal column for nerves, and so you can get rid of a nerve entrapment by doing that, or nerve compression by doing that. A very useful surgery in the right circumstances, can help a lot. You maintain the integrity of the mobility of the spine, so it's a great surgery as far as maintaining the mobility that is left. And so those surgeries, we can work directly over the surgical site. We can work the whole spine around that. Not a big deal at all to work on that once it's healed up. So that's something we do all the time. A large percentage of our practice has already had a surgery like that at some point in their lives. And we can work right over the top of that, no problem. The other type of a surgery is a fusion. It's a decent surgery in the right situations, and sometimes people don't have a choice on getting those. Those are the type of people that we really like. I've hoped that they would have seen a chiropractor before the surgery, but even so, sometimes it's necessary to have that surgery. The problem with that type of a surgery, and why we like to exhaust all of our conservative options first, is because you're left with cages, pins, screws, things like that in the spine. And with those fixtures in there, you create functional blocks in the spine. And then the spine purposely cannot share motion all the way through it. And so eventually what ends up happening is you start to see degenerative changes, or even tissue changes above and below those surgical sites. So the answer with those is we can still work on them, but we don't work directly over those fused sites. Obviously, where there's pins and screws, we can't manipulate or don't want to create more motion in there. That's why the fixture's there. That's why the hardware's there, is to preserve the structural integrity of that spinal segment. So, but we work around them a lot. So let's say you had a low back fusion. A lot of times we'll look at the mobility of the hips, strength of the glutes, things like that, where we're working underneath it to try and create a better foundation, or above it, because a lot of times the pain or the issues just move. And so we like to work around those areas. We don't work directly over them. But you can still be seen by a chiropractor, and they'll ask you a lot of questions about your surgery, try to get a little bit more information so they know exactly what's going on. A lot of times it's useful if you have imaging that they can have access to, or imaging that you bring with you, so that they know exactly what's going on with those segments. But the short answer is yes, we can work on you. If you have any other questions, feel free to let us know. Be happy to answer them for you. Leave a comment in the comment section below. Hit subscribe to our channel. We appreciate hearing from you. Thanks.